A very good morning to all. Myself, Dr. Jyoti Mallya, and welcome all to my presentation on galls. Galls are the typical outgrowths of plants that provide nourishment, protection, shelter to the insect or its progeny. Production of galls is considered as the most complex interaction between the plant and the insect. We studied the galls in common tree known as Gula in North India and Ati in South India, its scientific name Ficus racemosa, which belongs to the family Moraceae. We found that the gall was inspected by Parospila depressa, which is a hemipteran insect. We collected galls from Badlapur to Dombivli on the same time of day, that is 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. in the morning, and we took the measurement. After taking the measurement, we dissected them and observed under microscope. These are the photographs and morphological observation. In larval stages, we found 4 stages of larvae, and number of larvae are survived in each chambers, and we found there are 1 to 4 chambers which depend on the size of the galls. These are the microscopic observation of the larvae inside the galls, and after doing the biochemical test for carbohydrate and protein using the standard procedures, we found that protein was absent in the leaf containing the galls, and carbohydrates were present in both the normal and the gall sleeve. So we done the calorimetry test for quantitative measurement of the carbohydrate. For that, we divided the leaf containing galls into 2 parts, that is the green galls and the red galls. And before that, we also observed the presence of stomata, and we found that the leaf containing galls are stomata is absent. In the green galls and the red galls, we found high percentage of sugar, about 49 and 51 percentage of sugar is present in the galls containing the leaves, which is higher than the normal leaf. For concluding, we like to conclude that galls was formed by psyllids Parospila depressa in Ficus plant. It was observed that more than 1 larvae was present in single chamber. The galls are varied in size, number of chamber and texture according to the larvae. Stomata and the protein were absent in the leaf containing galls. The carbohydrate was present in both normal and the gall leaf qualitatively, but quantitatively the galls containing leaf show higher carbohydrate content than the normal leaf. Take away message from this presentation is galls in leaves reported overexpression of auxin and cytokinin, which help the growth of the plant and also protect the parasites. In references, we found that the galls are rich in bioactive compounds like phenolic compounds, quinones, flavonoids, steroids like etc., which can be used as drugs. And according to Chattopadhyay et al., their phytocompounds in galls show antiviral, antifungal, antihelminths, anti-inflammatory activities, and they are used in ethnomedicine from ancient times, and results in the field is very less, and more work has to be done to use the galls in the better way for the benefit of the society. I like to acknowledge all these people, especially principal and management, for the support. Thank you all.